Rules 112, Clause 6 of the Rules of Procedure of Parliament provides that, except with the permission of the Speaker, a member shall not absent himself or herself from 15 or more sittings of the House during any period when the House is continuously meeting. While chairing the House today, the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, threatened that she'll be forced to invoke this rule on the boycotting opposition legislators if they don't rescind their stance on the boycott.
Don't fight when you're out. You fight when you're inside here. You don't. Just like when you're in a home, a husband and a wife, don't run away, be there. So it is not good for us to go out and start lamenting from out. Let's be here.
However, the Speaker announced that the government will be ready on 21st November to present a comprehensive statement on issues of human rights violations, which form the cause of their House boycott.
The leader of this House, I'm going to invoke the rule on the 15 sittings. And I want you members to come to the House. Don't miss for the 15 sittings.
Upon receiving this information, the Chief Opposition Whip, John Baptist Nambeshe, rebuked the Speaker's pronouncements, saying Parliament is aware of their boycott, since the Leader of Opposition has been in constant communication with the Speaker over their absence.
For us who are in boycott, this particular opposition boycott, it is a constitutional right. And it was announced in broad daylight, and it is on record because this is a House of Records.
So far, the opposition has missed over 5 sittings while on boycott in protest of continued disappearance of their supporters, among other issues. Nambeshe insists that nothing will deter them from advocating for what they believe is right.
I highly doubt whether she would make such a statement. And in any case, it would be an intimidatory remark to make. And let me say this. This opposition, you people may think, is about to throw hands into the air. We shall not relent until issues of concern, grave concern of human rights violations is addressed, is responded to.
Meanwhile, there was a light moment in the House today as the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, returned to chair Parliament sittings for the first time since she gave birth to twins recently. Among addressed the House on the state of the twins, their father, and the family at large.
On a special note, I want to thank Mama Janet Museveni and His Excellency the President for the love you showed me. I thank in a special note again Japan, and still on a special note the Katikiro of Buganda.
Scenes of joyous celebrations dominated the floor of Parliament as members learned that House sittings would not last beyond 2 hours during the stewardship of the presiding officer, Anita Among, who is undergoing postpartum recovery.
I am not a civil servant for anybody to ask why has she come back from leave. I'm not on maternity leave. A politician does not have maternity leave. The law prescribes for a civil servant. So if I'm in good health, I come and serve my country.
Among registered her concerns with social media outbursts over her maternity situation.
The problem we have with the social media, there are doctors, there are nurses, there are gynecologists, there are pediatricians. They even want to be salongos when they cannot be salongos.
Led by the Prime Minister, Robina Nabanja, MPs powered the Speaker with congratulatory messages.
And so on behalf of government, I want to say that we are happy working with you. I also want to congratulate my Muzukuru, the Honorable Member of Parliament, who made it possible.
When somebody has just given birth, such a mother should avoid a stressful situation like sitting for so long. So it is true that we advise that you regulate the time you can be in a situation which prolongs stress and so forth.
You become the historical Cleopatra, Nefertiti, to Uganda, to Africa and the whole world.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.